But first, now to another scientific breakthrough. The planet is currently in the midst of an extinction crisis as global climate changes and habitats disappear. Species all over the world are at risk of being lost. Breeding these endangered animals is one of the tools researchers can use to combat this decline, but that can be difficult to accomplish. A recent innovation here in the U.S. has given some new hope for some wolf species. NewsHour science correspondent Nsikan Akpan has the story of the young puppies that may help save the rest of the pack.
It may be hard to believe, but these adorable puppies and how they came into the world might be the key to saving a whole host of endangered species. At the Smithsonian Conservation Biology Institute in Front Royal, Virginia, scientists are developing state-of-the-art reproduction techniques to try and save endangered species. At the institute, you'll find everything from cheetahs to black-footed ferrets. The scientists here are perfecting tools like artificial insemination and in vitro fertilization to help the breeding of those endangered animals. A marquee case is the maned wolf. They're an endangered member of the canid family, which includes wolves, foxes, and dogs. They're from South America. Smithsonian conservation biologist Nutrien Songesen says most of the wolf's forest habitat has been lost to farming and human development.
Right now, we estimate about 15,000 of them in the wild. But the problem with this species is that the habitat is gone. The 85% has lost, and only 2% of the natural habitat is protected. So the population in the future is not looking very bright because there's no home for them.
To save the species, she and her colleagues are trying to breed the wolves in captivity for future reintroduction to the wild. But she says that's tricky.
We hope that they will breed naturally, but sometimes that not always the case. You know, sometimes they have this incompatibility, so now they may not like each other and do not want to have anything to do with each other.
Maine wolves are monogamous, and females tend to be very particular when it comes to choosing a boyfriend or partner. That's why scientists need breeding tools like in vitro fertilization, or IVF. IVF is commonly used in humans. It first involves harvesting an egg from the female and putting it into a dish. You then insert the male sperm into the egg, creating an embryo, which is then implanted into the mother. But reproductive biologist Jennifer Nagashima says that for decades, scientists have struggled to make IVF work with dogs and wolves.
So I like to say that dogs are a little bit weird. They have a unique reproductive physiology, and that's part of why IVF has really been a challenge to develop over the past 40 years.
Nagashima says that's in part because canid reproductive systems have some particular quirks, like the fact that females just don't produce that many eggs.
Female dogs only cycle once or twice a year, and this is even more dramatic in wild canids who are seasonal. So you only have an ovulation event once a year. And even when that egg is ovulated, it requires another 2 to 3 days in the reproductive tract or the oviduct to mature and become fertilizable. So the result of these two things means that there aren't that many mature eggs available to develop technologies such as IVF.
So what Nagashima and her colleagues did was to troubleshoot the entire reproductive process. They started with basic dog breeds like beagles and cocker spaniels, and then they figured out the best way and time to harvest the eggs. They even found ways to give the male sperm a little boost by adding magnesium.
So when we added magnesium back in, it actually promoted the motility of the sperm, so the ability of it to swim.
So you just sprinkle a little bit of magnesium and makes it a better swimmer.
Yes, yes, exactly.
The resulting embryos were then frozen. From there, the team had to determine the best time to implant the embryos into a surrogate mom. Here's why. The would-be moms had to be exactly in sync with the development of the embryos. Yet, even after implantation, the team had to constantly monitor the health of the surrogates to make sure nothing went wrong with their pregnancies. And 2 months later, success. 7 healthy puppies were born.
The puppies were born July 10th of 2015, and so they're just over 5 months old right now, and they're adorable, healthy bundles of terror and joy.
The final technique was published in the journal PLOS ONE, and the story of the puppies received worldwide attention. Nagashima says these young dogs are proof the technique can work, and so now the hope is to use it on threatened species.
The hope for the Maine wolves and other endangered canid species is that we'll be able to use this technology to help their reproduction, so to produce pups where otherwise we might not be able to. So for example, a lot of times in these very small populations, if you have a female that passes away before she's been able to breed, we would really like to be able to take her ovaries, collect the eggs, mature them, and then use IVF to produce embryos that represent her as a mother.
Most of the litter were adopted by the researchers themselves because A, who wouldn't want one of these scientific marvels? And B, just look at him.
This is Cannon. He is a Cocker Spaniel Beagle mix.
This is Buddy. He's a little bunch of joy. Okay.
You tell your beagle what he might mean for the survival of future relatives?
I do. I tell him every day that he's very important. He's a superstar and, you know, but, you know, he's still a puppy. I'm not really sure that he understands what that means yet. But hopefully one day he will understand.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Nsikan Akpan in Front Royal, Virginia.